Hey everyone, it's G from OG Creations. In this video, I'm going to show you how I recreated the Great Hall, and then it's time to party, as Sean finally gets to explore and play as we celebrate the big 1-1. I started by removing most of the furniture in our living room so I could hang the Great Hall themed photo backdrop that I printed from Etsy. I purchased 4 Camelot themed columns from Shindig's Party and Prom and put those together a few days before. It took time, but I finally found banners that I wanted to use. I attached each banner to the top of the columns using clear packing tape. I secure command strip wire toggle hooks to hang the 4 flaming fire cauldrons. The making of video will be linked below. I head into my tie-dyeing studio so I can work on the Great Hall table. I use my work table and cover it with rustic wood contact paper. I then move it upstairs and keep it low to the ground so it's the perfect Ashan height. Back upstairs, I start hanging the 125 flameless 8-inch and 11-inch tapers. Again, I'm securing them to the ceiling using clear packing tape. Honestly, this took some time, much more than I had planned. Hell, putting the batteries in the candles took time. What you're not seeing are the 3+ hours it took Ken and I to tie clear fishing line in varying lengths to the flames of each candle. Someone just woke up from a birthday nap and is checking out the dad's progress. Using hurricane candle holders I purchased years ago, I fill each with plastic gems and backlight them to create the house points. Ken and I are turning on all the candles, galaxy projectors, and cauldrons. Each column will be uplit with coordinating banner colors. Sweets are set out. Pumpkin juice is made and ready to serve from the Hogshead pitcher I purchased from Universal Studios. And it's finally time.
Welcome to Hogwarts.
Let's do a quick walkthrough before we bring out the birthday boy.
Real the ceiling. It's just bewitched to look like the night sky.
Hey look, Neville's got a remembrall.
I purchased a small Hogwarts steamer trunk from the Harry Potter shop in the UK and personalized it with the Sean's initials. I filled it with all of his Hogwarts needs, a Marauder's map, rememberall, Gryffindor robes, wand, and even an Ashan-sized Hedwig. Looks like it's a perfect fit. Each year, I create a kitty-friendly birthday cake using a bit of food coloring and pure tuna and sculpting it. This year, I created a dragon. I guess he's waited long enough. It's time to sing happy birthday and blow out the candles. Make a wish. Happy birthday, buddy. While Ashan enjoys his cake, please remember to like and subscribe to OG Creations channel and hit the bell icon to get notifications on new tie-dye tutorials and over-the-top cat dad videos like this one. It took forever to find Harry Potter themed cat toys. I used ping pong balls and pipe cleaners to create these bubbly, steaming cauldrons filled with kitty treats. Ashan always loves getting new toys. It's like they are his little treasures. He likes having them piled up in a large circle with a little Ashan-sized hole in the middle so he can sleep surrounded by them. For weeks after getting a new lot, you can tell he wants you to join him as he shows off his new babies. The fast-paced thumps of his paws and tiny little chirps lets me know it's time to play again. I would do anything for this little guy. He has been at my side every day since he adopted me almost 11 years ago. He is the most polite, kind, and love-filled being I have ever met. He taught me how to truly love someone. I mean, look at this face. He melts my heart every day. He is my everything. Happy 11th birthday, little man. Papa loves you very much. Thanks for sharing this special day with us, and until next time.